Good afternoon and welcome to the Hartford's Top 5 Part 1 webinar hosted by Stuckey and Company. We look like we still have some people logging in, have great attendance today, so I want to thank everybody for coming. A few things before we get started. First, I guess, you know, questions, if you can, you can ask questions in the question area of the GoToWebinar control panel on the right-hand side of your screen. Or you could ask using the chat functionality on the right-hand side as well. We get all of those questions. We'll try to get them in the question and answer section of this webinar, but if we don't get to it, we'll definitely do a follow-up email after the webinar. So I guess that's the next piece. We will do a follow-up email. We will have some materials ready for you, an appetite guide and a few videos and coverage analyzer tools that we can share with you. And then we will probably identify some other things that we can send you, stretch coverages or business income flyers, some things like that that describe the coverages a little bit better. So let's go ahead and get started. So in 2019, Stuckey & Company will celebrate 28 years as a specialty MGA and national wholesale broker, offering our agents access to solid A-rated carriers like the Hartford, Safeco, Travelers, Chubb, just to name a few. I think we have 61 carriers today, personal lines, commercial lines, surplus lines, and professional lines. Today we have what's called a 151 promise. We started that a couple of years ago. And that is basically an in by one, out by five, in by five, out by one the next day, for complete submissions and service requests. This year, we're adding a single point of contact for our agents and five levels of commissions. So, when you get appointed, or as you, I see some agents that are also appointed with us, we assign a single point of contact for you to navigate through each line of business. And then each carrier and program has five levels of commission. So we start, there's no fee to join. There is no volume commitment. But if you have zero to 50,000 in production, that's our entry fee, our entry point. 50 to 250 is the next level, 250 to a million, million to 2.5, and 2.5 and above. So we can talk a little bit more about that if we have time or if you'd like to. Here's what we do. We're specialty MGAs, really in our core. So we, most of the time, we create the program, underwrite to it, rate, quote, bind, issue the policy, endorse, renew, invoice, we report to you and the carriers. We integrate the systems between our agents and our carriers. Sometimes we handle the claims, but most of the time it's handled by the carrier. And we always market and train. These are our eight specialty programs. Safety Tech is a technology product. Aspire A&E is for architects and engineers. Harbor Guard is for marinas and boat dealerships. MPL is, we have about 350 different classes of miscellaneous professional liability that we can write. We have a green energy insurance program called Element. We write personal lines, home, auto, boat, and high value home. We're rolling out a online rating platform now for our agents as a comparative rater. We have a commercial lines product that we'll talk about today. It includes coverages like BOP, comp, auto, bonds, EPLI, D&O, all that fun stuff. And then if it falls outside of the commercial lines, we have a not admitted surplus lines department that we can quote some of that a little bit higher risk business. Next, I'd like to thank Claire Coleman, agency education consultant for the Hartford, Tracy Hagee Kelly, executive sales representative for small commercial at the Hartford, and Tyler Bechtold, business development representative for Stuckey & Company, for presenting and making themselves available for questions during and after the webinar on the availability and advantages of the product. So let me transfer control to Claire.
I'm sorry, guys. I thought you could see. Can you guys see my screen?
It's coming up right now. There we go.
All right, perfect. Can you guys see my screen? Is everything good, crystal clear?
Yeah, you might. It looks like it's, if you put it to a presentation mode, it'll be bigger.
Okay. Is that better?
It is. Looks great. And you're loud and clear, too.
Perfect, perfect. So, guys, today I am Claire Coleman. Thank you, Dwight, for the introduction. I am Claire Coleman of the agency education team. This does talk about our small commercial top 10 markets, but we're going to break this up to be a little more personalized session for you guys. So we're going to do two sessions. This session, we're going to go through our top five markets, and then the next session, we'll go through our other top five markets. Just for timing perspective for you guys, in the event you guys have questions, as well as you can kind of think about all of our industries, you know, holistically, and kind of get a sneak preview of things we'll talk about next time. So let's go ahead and get started. So thanks again for joining us today. We're going to spend some time reviewing our Hartford Small Commercial top five offering today, and we'll finish up the next time talking about the second half of our top 10 offerings. By the end of this session, we hope that you're able to describe our top five target industries, even though I know it says 10, we're just really breaking that up to be a little more tailored for you guys. We hope that you distinguish the Hartford specific coverages and that you're able to employ a total account solution for your small business customers. Now let's start off talking about what we mean when we're talking about our top 10 industries and why we're focusing on these industries. Our top 10 focuses involves a combination of our traditional target industries and our expanded target industries. The list is short, but the opportunity for growth is significant. You may look at this list and think, well, that's what everyone wants. While that may be true, the Hartford does them better than really anyone else. So let's go ahead and talk about each of these industries. So we're going to talk about the first about four industries on the left today. So we're going to talk about our business and personal services. We're going to talk about our finance and insurance. We're going to talk about our professional services, our technology. And then next time, we're going to talk about our contractors, our lessors, risk and real estate, our manufacturers, our restaurants, retailers, and wholesalers. So at the Hartford, small business is big business. We were the first insurer to start and dedicate small business unit more than 30 years ago. Since then, we've become a leading insurance provider to small commercial customers by offering tailored coverage options. You will find that we are true innovators in this industry, from our industry-leading Spectrum policy to our pay-as-you-go workers' compensation premium billing services. We are always striving to provide the best coverages and customer experience to your small business clients. And we don't want to rest on our laurels. We continue to strive to innovate. We were the first market to bring out data breach coverage about 5 years ago. And with our most recent introduction of new coverages, such as business income extension for cloud service interruption, which again, we were the first market to provide this coverage, We even have a patent on our coverage, as well as our enhancing our data breach coverages and our franchise upgrade coverages. So let's take a look at really our thresholds, and let's dive into what some of these top industries look like today. So this is where you're going to see our small business owner policy and workers' compensation. We did touch on our definitions because we just wanted you to take a look at the bigger picture perspective. We did increase them, and we are talking about increasing them as well. And the reason really increased them is that we heard from you guys as our agents that middle market was at one place and small commercial was at one place, and there was a gap in between. We really are working to minimize those gaps so you can write those larger accounts quickly and easily, as well as those smaller accounts as well, you know, the $500 accounts that you were writing prior. So really think about, you know, as you're looking at this chart, our financial services, as well as our business and professional services, we can go up to $12 million in payroll there for workers' compensation. $40 million in property values for both financial services and business and personal services. Retail, pretty large there, $30 million in property values. And manufacturing, you're seeing here, $15 million in property values, as well as sales up to $10 million. Payroll, even as high up to $3 million. So more to come if we'll bump them up again. But I really want you guys to think about us, not on the smaller accounts, but the larger accounts as well. So let's talk about one of those first industries that we talked about in the beginning of the slide, business and personal services. We know that this is an incredibly fast-growing and diverse sector, encompassing everything from beauty shops to photographers. And while these small business owners may be experts in their field, they are looking for a trusted advisor for their insurance needs. An expert who makes understanding a complex array of coverages simple and easy to understand. The Hartford is here to help. Our appetite for these small business opportunities encompasses more than $4 million in business, representing approximately $2.7 billion in combined premium. For example, we can write service business, which has a $20 million in property values per location and sales up to about $13 million per account, as well as payroll up to $12 million for monoline workers' compensation. Now, we really want to talk about what we're looking to avoid, and really, we know that businesses where slips and falls are frequent, but we know that this is common in the industry today. So we're really excited to talk to you about this appetite. Now, the Hartford Spectrum Bot policy is perfect for these type of small businesses, including key coverages that are important to their industry. Computers are pervasive in almost all businesses these days, and our Spectrum stretch form automatically includes coverage for computers and media while providing coverage against virus damage to equipment, software, and data. You can also go ahead and endorse data breach coverage to further protect sensitive customer data. We've recently enhanced our data breach coverage to offer more flexibility. And again, we talked about it in the last session, but we've introduced our business income extension for cloud service interruption, as well as business income extension for off-premises operations. These unique coverages will really help set you apart. Because many businesses in this class will also build a client base located in their area close to their location, should a property loss occur, many business owners will choose to rebuild rather than relocate. So business income coverage is vital to reimburse the business owner for loss of revenue and operating costs during that closure. We also recently, again, introduced our business income extension for off-premise operation coverage. This is exciting and a new coverage. And this will cover the loss of business income when business operations are suspended because business personal property is damaged while it's away from the scheduled premises. Think about a photographer, for example. it's a great way to enhance that policy. But it's not just Spectrum. We also have an industry-leading workers' compensation policy and commercial auto policies available. And if you write more than one policy on an account, you can enjoy a multi-policy discount on our Spectrum BOP policy. Typically, in most states, it's about 5% that you will get that multi-policy discount. Now, business personal services encompasses industries such as your photographers, videographers, your nail salons, day spas, items of that nature, or really when we're talking about our business and personal services and what type of appetite we're looking for there. So I hope you guys have a good appetite for what we're looking for. So let's jump into our finance and insurance and what we're looking for in this industry. So here we see that we are quoting a number of financial planners, finance companies, real estate appraisers, and even people like you guys, insurance agents. They all fall under this category. Finance and insurance is one of the top 10 fastest growing industries. But as the industry grows, so does the risk it faces. You guys know, as an insurance agent, you are uniquely qualified to help these clients prepare for the unexpected. When you are looking to place a finance or insurance risk with the Hartford, keep in mind we will write accounts up to $40 million in annual sales, up to $20 million in property values, and we can go up to $15 million on monoline workers' compensation. So pretty large appetite there. Now, all of you fall into this category. So really, I hope, encourage you, to think about us if you are running up against, you know, remarketing your insurance agency policy. Now, what we typically like to avoid in this type of industry is property management. At this time, we are just not looking to write that type of exposure today. But because the financial and insurance industries are so reliant on technology, it's also important to offer the right coverage options to manage this risk. Our Spectrum policy makes it easy to tailor that coverage specifically for this market group. Again, our stretch endorsement has you covered with damage to computer equipment, software, and data from a virus, as well as resulting business income loss. And with all that financial information you might have, as well as personal identifiable information, these business owners should, you know, think about quoting data breach. It's a natural fit. And don't forget, again, our business income extension for cloud service interruption is a great way to enhance that coverage. Also, some of the largest investments a financial or insurance companies will make is their employees. So it's important that you know that we do have a great workers' compensation product. And the Hartford's workers' comp policy sets the standard for value, innovation, and injured work. We have a work team approach, which helps get injured workers back to work faster. On average, 6 days faster, along with access to over 500,000 healthcare providers who are experienced in workplace injury. And actually, I was just on a call, so I believe we are now up to about 1 million healthcare providers who are experienced in workplace injuries. So really great reason to start quoting that workers' compensation with us for these types of industries. And don't forget about our commercial auto policy with our extended broad form for no additional cost. So great reason there as well. But let's talk about those professional services. It's one that I'm sure you've heard about that we quote a number of industries on. It really isn't just a single industry. It's more like a dozen. Think about your doctors, your lawyers, your vets, your engineers, and more that are all included in this term. And they all need to protect their assets. The thing is, those assets can vary wildly in this group. A doctor might have an x-ray machine, but an engineer might be concerned about drafting equipment. Veterinarians might be concerned about professional liability exposures. Of course, the Hartford is able to help them all. We have a broad appetite for this market group, and when you're working with a business owner and in professional services, keep in mind that we can go up to $15 million in property value per location. We can go up to $15 million in sales per location. We can write and monoline workers' compensation payroll up to $12 million, as well as monoline auto fleets up to 25 vehicles. So something to keep in mind when thinking about it. So actually, I apologize. We can go up to $30 million in sales per policy, not $15 million. So I do apologize if I said that. Now, keep in mind that you can write those monoline auto policy accounts, and you can receive that multi-policy discount if you write all lines with us. As well as when quoting the Hartford, we do have a pay in full discount on both the auto and business owner's policy. So another reason to just offer that advantage. Now, what we're looking to avoid typically in this industry is veterinarians who treat livestock or exotic animals. Something we definitely would stay away from today. Because this market group is so diverse, there are a number of stretch endorsements to choose from tailored coverages for each type of business. But there are also a number of coverages included in our basic spectrum policy that have a broad appeal for those professional services. For example, data and software, which covers physical damage to computer equipment, software, and data, as well as valuable papers and records. Many professional services are required by law to store valuable documents for a certain time, as well as since periods are dictated by law. And because some professional service firms often entertain clients at things like holiday parties or golf outings, we automatically provide that host liquor liability. Also, I mentioned earlier that some professionals may be concerned about professional liability. Well, professional liability can be added to most of our spectrum policies and ICONs. But it doesn't stop with spectrum. Our industry-leading workers' compensation policy offers not only broad coverage, but also flexible billing in a way of payroll billing, like we stated before. So think about that in mind when thinking about ways that, you know, we can differentiate ourselves, as well as our auto policy. And it does have that auto broad form with 19 great coverages, including loan and lease gap coverage, as well as hybrid replacement. So let's talk about our technology appetite. Technology companies are ahead of the curve. Although the kind of innovation that really can lead to success, it can help create higher levels of risk. No one understands these risks better than the Hartford. We've been helping to protect technology risk for over 30 years. We have a broad appetite that includes software and computer-related services, such as also web designers, telecommunications, and electronics manufacturing. Now, when reviewing a technology account, we will go up to $30 million in property values per location and $50 million in sales per policy. Now, you're seeing a little bit different appetite for technology manufacturing as well as our values, and that's because we consider them in our manufacturing industry. Now, things that we will avoid in this industry are electronics manufacturers with a clean room as well as without. So if they have a lot of wet processes taking place, it might be something we stay away from, as well as maybe some dry process in place. But if you ever have a concern, Dwight and his team is always able to navigate that for you. Now, technology businesses are insuring assets, which are less tangible than many traditional risks. For example, a florist would be concerned with protecting their building and content, but a technology small business owner is more concerned with being able to ensure the quality of their product and deliver on promises made in a contract. Now, one of the most important things you can offer your customer is our technology professional liability. Our fail-safe suite of professional liability products was designed specifically for our tech businesses. With three levels of increasing protection, we have the right coverage for your technology account. Now, we are talking about mega here, but we're typically now endorsing giga to our spectrum policy. It is a great way to increase that coverage if your client needs that E&O coverage. Now, you can also add data breach coverage to guard your clients against losses due to loss or theft of customer personal identifiable information, and as well as our technology service extension plus, and that is coverage to protect for bodily injury, personal and advertising injury, or property damage to a third party. You know, for example, a tech company, and have an employee is working at a client's office and it damages a rack which holds their server. It would be typically covered under our tech services extension plus. And again, another option that many people don't consider when working with that tech industry is those international exposures. If your tech client sells their products or services outside of the US and has foreign licenses selling abroad on their behalf, or even has internet sales or advertising, you should consider offering that international stretch endorsement. This endorsement offers key property and liability coverages that a company occasionally doing business internationally would need. As with any account, if you have any questions, we do have a dedicated technology underwriter just to underwrite this line of business. So a great way if you ever need help navigating this. Now we are wrapping up today, and we will talk to you guys next time about our additional top five industries. But as you walk away, I know it's saying to write your top 10 accounts of the Hartford, and we do hope you do that. But really think about these industries and things that we can do for you and your clients. Don't forget to really quote all lines of business as long as we're eligible, so your clients can qualify for that multi-policy discount. And contact your underwriter or sales representative if you ever have any questions, as well as anyone at Stuckey & Company. They're always there to help, as well as our ICON team. They're there to help as well. Go to our agency self-service site and find these handy resources in the ICON tab for quoting and issuing businesses for all lines of business. Also, let us know if you're interested in learning anything else. But we do have these sessions going all year. So I love to hear from you guys in the chat and talk to you guys and catch up about any questions that you might have. So as you're walking away, you know, again, I hope you're walking away with you're able to describe our top industries we've talked about today. You're able to distinguish the Hartford specific coverages. And you are employing a total account solution for your small business customers. So with that, Dwight, I will pass it back over to you if there are any questions or anything else to wrap up today.
Right on. Well, thank you, Claire. Appreciate it. And, you know, lots and lots of good stuff. So, and we also are probably setting some records again on the number of questions. So we only have literally like 2 minutes to keep it within time. I'll try to answer a few of these and then I'll give each one of you a call or Tyler can give you a call and go over the questions. So the first question is, I have a retailer with a little bit over 50 million in property values, and the question is, will you look at it? I'll take this one. And I, you know, if most of the time Hartford's middle market mirrors their eligibility mirrors that of the small commercial, or is very close to it, and middle market can write some of the larger accounts if we can't put it on the spectrum. So we'll try to put it on the spectrum policy right off the bat, split it up by location. And if we can't do that, we'll go to middle market. The next question is, can we get a list of the stretch forms? And Claire, you and I talked about that the last time. We actually have a list, and I'll forward that list on the follow-up email this afternoon, and I'll include a link to download each one of those forms. It's pretty cool. You know, it's a stretch coverage for each industry. And a lot of the times you can get coverage on the stretch and remove it off the standard policy and save the customer a little bit of money. Here's a commercial auto question, maybe just a couple questions. Can you write commercial auto? And there's also a couple questions about monoline auto and comp. So we can write commercial auto. Most of the time it's going to be with supported business. And we cannot write any type of transportation risk, so or anything more than really a personal, you know, vehicle. I think the weight is 20,000 pounds. This particular question is in California, but I think it is nationwide. We write monoline comp. And Tracy, I know you're there too. Correct me if I'm wrong, but monoline comp everywhere in the country. Hartford is a very, very strong comp market. Yep. And I'll include some pay-as-you-go information too in the follow-up email. But monoline auto is that a no on every class?
It's not. I'm sorry, Claire, did you want to answer it, or is it okay for me to go ahead?
Go for it.
So generally speaking, if we have an appetite for the general liability, then we can look at monoline auto for most industries. Some industries like contractors or restaurants, those we absolutely have to have a supporting line with. But for classes like a retail operation or professional services or business services, we can do those monoline auto as long as we have an appetite for the GL. And the reason for that is that we'll write the monoline auto this year with the hope or the expectation that down the road we'll have an opportunity to cross-sell for those other lines of business. So we really want to make sure that where we are writing monoline auto, we have an alignment with appetite so that we could pick up the other lines as well.
Right on, yeah. Perfect. Another question is, do we have an SIC code or SIC code list that corresponds to the top 10? I know on online we can do a search for the SIC code as well as the other code, you know, the Hartford Spectrum codes, but we don't really have a published list with those SICs, do you?
I'm not aware of one. I can search for it if you'd like me to, but I'm not aware of one. I'll see what I can find.
Yeah. So, you know, what I can do is I can give you a follow-up call, and we can talk about the opportunity, see what you're looking for. I can do a search, and, you know, I know I have, we identify in our database SICs based on the product. So I have some of that. And we can do a search if you're looking to do a search on SIC code. I can do that for you too. So I'll follow up with that afterwards. And one last question, and maybe it shouldn't be the last question, Florida property, it's a Florida property question. And it looks like an agent has a medical office building in Florida. Can we include wind? And it looks like it's about $1 million piece of property.
So I can answer that as well. Generally speaking, we are not going to have much of an appetite for property exposures and wind zone areas, including Florida. Certainly, Dwight, I know you have E&S capabilities that could have access for the property, could have placement for the property, and Hartford could possibly look at the general liability and the workers' compensation.
Yeah, you bet. And it's also based on, I've seen Hartford look at it more seriously on some of the best risks. Central Florida, best, you know, construction and that type of thing. But you're right. So we have a we're national wholesale brokers with Maxim and Markel, and they'll take a look at that as well. And I think, you know, we also have a couple admitted markets that'll look at it. So with that, I have a list of materials that I'll forward out. Pay-as-you-go, workers' comp. We have a new thresholds and definitions sheet that gives the new sales and payroll numbers for 2019. I have a data breach, a flyer that I'll also include, and those stretch coverages, including that international stretch that you had. And I'll also include contact information for Tyler and Megan in our office, and who will be your agency contact. So with that, I'd like to thank everybody for coming. And Tracy, I want to thank you and Claire also for, you know, being here and presenting and answering the questions.
Thanks so much for allowing us to be a part of it, Dwight. We really appreciate it.
Right on. Have a great one, guys.
Thank you. Have a great one, guys. Talk to you next time.